Meanwhile, a notorious level crossing where 84 people have either been killed or injured has claimed another victim. Police say the latest person was killed after ignoring closed boom gates as he tried to beat a train.
The boom gates were down and warning bells ringing, but the split-second decision to beat a train cost one man his life.
The boom gates are there for a reason, they're for people's safety, and if you disregard them, then unfortunately avoidable tragedies like this can occur.
Paramedics worked on the 31-year-old Werribee man, but he couldn't be revived. The accident happened during after-work peak in front of horrified onlookers and numerous warning signs.
How many more people do we need to lose at this intersection? Absolutely, it's appalling.
Helen Dudock's friend lost a child at nearby Ginnifer Station. She points out more than a dozen schools border the train line that she's dubbed a death trap.
12, 13 in the university. Within a small area.
And after seeing the tragedy last night, she's frustrated.
We really do need an underground line. Hopefully the government's listening. I really, really want something to be done.
Locals have spent years lobbying the state government for the crossing to be removed. And while a commitment has been made to build an underpass, no funding has been attached.
The Premier and Transport Minister today pointed to a list of other stations earmarked for safety work.
Well, we've already started and announced that we're going to start on Mitcham Road and Rooks Road and Springvale Road.
The opposition says the government's priorities have been elsewhere.
At funding level crossings in Brighton for your political purposes, instead of making safety a priority, well, that's pretty ordinary.
Alicia Morrison, 10 News.